And our goaltenders brought to you by your Southeast Michigan Ford dealers. Peter Mrazek for Detroit, a bit of a struggle in the win on Tuesday, but came up with big saves to preserve the victory. Seventh straight start in the absence of Jimmy Howard. And 6'7", Ben Bishop, the tallest goaltender, makes a sixth consecutive start. He lost in Carolina Tuesday, but he's won 8 of his past 10 decisions and fifth in the NHL in wins with 24. This is Amalie Arena. Fourth moniker for this building. 1996, it came into being. Amalie named after an oil company. So it's gone through some names, gone through some transitions, as has this Tampa team. But with goaltending that they get from Ben Bishop, they're a force to be reckoned with in the Atlantic Division. This is the something gotta give night. The Red Wings have won 6 in a row. Tampa here at home has won 8 straight. Lightning's power play has struggled, as Mick showed you. Red Wing penalty killing hasn't been very good. The referees are Marc Jarnet and François Saint-Laurent. And we're underway with Henrik Zetterberg at center, Justin Abdelkader on the left, Gus Nyquist on the right, and the top line that Mick spoke of off the top, including Tyler Johnson, number 9, along with Andre Palat, number 18, and Nikita Kucherov, number 86, as we get our first stop in play in this game.
Well, is the case. The road team has to put their lineup in first. Mike Babcock got the Zetterberg line on the sheet, and John Cooper responds by saying, I want my good young centerman that's got 17 goals to go up against the veteran Henrik Zetterberg, at least to start with. And we'll see what develops from there. What we do know is the Red Wings will need to be a lot better tonight than they were on Tuesday night in Florida. And that's out of play because they got a 5-2 lead as Florida stood around for about 30 minutes. And then after that, they took the foot off the gas and had to hang on to win 5-4. 2 points is 2 points, though, but they know that this Tampa team is a pretty quick team, and this could be a track meet tonight, Ken.
Both teams on rolls, and the Red Wings have passed 6 on the road, are 5-1. Johnson and Zetterberg, and Zetterberg's been great with 5 goals and 9 points his past 4 games. Tyler Johnson with 48 points in the season, ninth best in the National Hockey League, and that leads his team. Cronwall back for Jonathan Erickson. The good outlet feed went off the stick of Zetterberg as Bishop is out to play it. Little wheel round, one in behind for Schuster. Big defenseman, number 62, that went over Tyler Johnson's stick. And the Red Wings and Lightning will both make changes here in the first minute of this hockey game. Pavel Datsyuk off his skate, recovered, sent it to an open wing. Datsyuk out there with Helm, who forces the issue. Turning with it quickly was Anton Strålman, the free agent signing who leads the Tampa defense in points. And the Lightning in ice time at nearly 23 minutes a night. Datsyuk was knocked down in behind. Tatar got forced at the line. At the puck come back, an aggressive Lightning forecheck there. Strålman put one ahead for Ryan Callahan, the former Ranger captain. And these two current win streaks going here at home for the Tampa Bay Lightning, 8. For the Red Wings overall with 6. The Red Wings haven't won 7 consecutive since January of 2012. And you can see how good the Red Wing power play has been during the 6-game winning streak.
Tampa Bay with that 1.6 goals against at home. Pretty tough stuff with a big Ben Bishop in goal.
Back to get it, Jason Garrison. Came over from Vancouver for a second round pick last June. Knocked down partially there by Sheahan, who's out with Weiss and Glendening. This was the big line for the Red Wings Tuesday in South Florida. Knocked off stride with Cedric Paquette, number 13. Sheahan was hooked, couldn't get to the puck as a result. Puck knocked it. What a save! And they score on the rebound! Paquette!
Well, the Red Wings won't be happy with what just happened here before the goal. Take a look at this. Riley Sheahan, we're just a little bit behind it. He looked like he got hooked off stride, and the puck ends up going to the front of the net. Nobody covers in behind, and Let's see if we can pick it up on this angle right here. Yeah, Riley Sheehan right over here on your right side. Can't get this thing cleared. We'll try it again. Yep. Okay, there we go.
Great first save there by Peter Mrazek, but the rebound went through. And Tampa gets the first goal of this game. Red Wings had scored first in five of the six games on the winning streak. They did not score first in the 6-4 come-from-behind win, and a hand pass called there over Buffalo. Other than that, during the six games, they'd scored first in each one, but trail this one tonight 1-0 on the Cedric Paquette goal, his seventh of the season. Paquette getting his seventh. Tampa Bay's spread their scoring around. They've got seven players with at least 10 goals. Tied with Winnipeg and Pittsburgh for best in the league. Zetterberg getting over there to get it on the near side. This is a sellout crowd here tonight at Amalie Arena. Run on here by Johnson. Johnson goes in there after that puck out with the top line for the Lightning. Well, as we say, they do have Stamkos, their team leader in terms of goals with 26. But this carried in here by Kucherov. Kucherov with 43 points, and he just got rocked back there.
Nice job by DeKaiser.
As Helm sends one ahead, too far for Tatar. Near side here for Schuster. 6'8 defenseman wheeled one in back of the net. Callahan battling there with Cronwall. Callahan in there first. Knocked off Stamkos' stick. Over to Valtteri Filppula, the former Red Wing, the familiar number 51, and a good move to outlet here by Tatar. Datsyuk kicked it ahead. Datsyuk right in on goal. Saved by Bishop, and the rebound just missed there by Tatar.
Tic-tac-toe there by Datsyuk, boy.
And a great recovery there by Datsyuk to take it away from Stamkos. It'll be interesting to see as this night moves along if it's Datsyuk against Stamkos throughout. And what happens with the Tyler Johnson unit?
And a couple of pretty good moves there, first by Tatar and then by Datsyuk. Juking and jiving to go to the net and get a scoring chance.
Nice bring in here by Steven Weiss. Weiss coming through has been hot lately with 5 points his past four games. Mike Babcock has used the... box. Team's back at full strength. Knocked ahead for Jonathan Drouin. Played back to Barbario. Tipped through by Killorn, but not deep. As Anderson's able to get it out, but they went off a stick and out of play. So with that, with eight gone in the first, we'll step out on Fox Sports Detroit.
Well, I told you we would revisit the Tampa goal, and we will hear a call that I thought could have been made. Hold it right there. Riley Sheahan is going to play the puck here. He does not touch the puck, and they may have let him off the hook for that, but nonetheless, he's hooked and he can't play it. When it's a turnover like this, when you don't expect it, look at all these guys up here, and in behind they get, and Paquette gets the goal to make it 1-0. So probably that play, if it looks like that later in this hockey game, will get called, and that would be the argument of the Red Wings early in this one.
Deep into the Red Wing end, back to get it. Here's DeKeyser, moved ahead for Abdelkader. Zetterberg quickly moved that puck for Nyquist. He got forced at the line. As Tyler Johnson carries back in. Late man coming. Oh, a rocket there from Jason Garrison, who's got that terrific shot. When he was with Florida, what some years he had. Nyquist back in. Never quite produced the same in Vancouver as he did south of here.
Funny how that happens with guys.
Yeah. They say DeKeyser didn't keep the puck in, so we'll get a faceoff coming up. There's the head coach of the Tampa Bay Lightning, John Cooper, who spent 3 years in the American Hockey League, won a Calder title as well. A dual citizen. His mom's American, his dad's Canadian. And he was one of the, he was the head coach when basically these two rosters went head-to-head in 2013 in the Calder Cup final in the American Hockey League. 18 current players in this game tonight played in the Calder Cup final that Grand Rapids beat Syracuse 4-2. John Cooper was their head coach at the time, but almost 8 of their players and 10 Red Wings played in that American Hockey League title championship series that Grand Rapids won. So both these teams very familiar with one another, and certainly John Cooper very familiar with a lot of the Red Wing players from the American Hockey League days.
It's Grand Rapids had this stranglehold on that series, and they let them back in, basically. Ended up going to a seventh game. Led it 3-0. So
Peter Mrazek was the netminder, and how great he was. Tatar. Helm tries to get to it. There's Tatar on the puck. Fed it back into the middle. Datsyuk had hustled over, but couldn't keep it in. Brendan Smith moved it back. As Ouellette gives him the puck back. Glendening will get it in. Sheahan up there along with Weiss, who's got the puck. Then Weiss muscled off the puck. Knocked down was Killorn. Brought back in by Glendening. Tried to make a pass in front, but a good diving play by the great defenseman Victor Hedman. Xavier Ouellette with a backhand shot that Bishop nudged aside. Hedman played one to the near side. Backhanded by Glendening high. Knocked out of the air by Ouellette for Smith, who nearly lost it, but able to recover with Jonathan Drouin up there. And he's fast, number 27. He won the skills competition in Columbus as the fastest skater last Saturday night. Here's Jonathan Drouin. Here's Yurko. And he was checked as Kucherov got a piece of him. And you know, this line, as we mentioned, has been so good in the plus department. They're tough to get some chances again against offensively. Into the slot and knocked away. There's Buck Palat. He's in there for Tampa.
This would be a matchup that I imagine Mike Babcock wouldn't mind against this line, his checking fourth line.
Anderson goes after that puck, but knocked away from him by Strahlman. Anton Strahlman with it. Went to the cup final with the New York Rangers. The Red Wings had interest in signing Strahlman as an unrestricted free agent. Got a 5-year deal and $22 million from Steve Yzerman. Abdelkader carries in, wrist shot, easily handled by Bishop. Well, the Red Wings right now a point ahead of Tampa Bay in the Atlantic Division. Did Mike Babcock last summer think they'd be where they are? We'll find out in a moment.
I've said this a number of times. If you'd asked me on July 5th where we'd be, I didn't think we'd be near where we're at. And, you know, people can tell you different, but all the experts said we weren't going to make the playoffs. And you know, I thought ourselves we weren't sure. So we've had great growth on our team. Our team's been a team that's gotten better. And we got to keep getting better.
Yeah, one key word that he used there, growth. And I don't think anybody could have predicted the growth and maturation of people like Nyquist, Tatar, and Riley Sheahan, specifically those three. I mean, there's been a lot of other contributors for sure. Darren Helm's having a great year and so on. Glenn Denning and all the guys we've talked about. But those three, boy, oh boy.
Here's Helm right up front with it. Oh. Scores!
Speaking of the devil. Wow. What a play by Helm, and they stood around like a bunch of pylons on the side of the road and watched him, and he backed out, and Bishop went down, and as big as he is, still there's room under the crossbar and over the shoulder. Look at him down already. He's down. He's on his knees, and he stays there. Oh, my. And look at this. You could throw a blanket over three of them, and Bishop's going, oh, I can't believe it. I'm telling you, these goaltenders and our guys back in the studio will talk about it. The way they play the game today, they're down, sliding around on their pads, and up in the top is always there. If you can hit it, it's a home run, and Darren Helm does it there to make it a 1-1 hockey game. And Helmer's ninth of the year, I believe. It's ninth or tenth for Darren. Yeah, his ninth of the year. Boy, oh boy. Talk about getting scoring from everywhere. We talked a lot about Glenn Denning, and Helm is another great story, having missed the last couple of years to injury.
And that was against the Stamkos line with Filppula and Callahan, line that struggled defensively.
Wow. For sure.
Brought in here by Hedman.
Filppula is a terrible, terrible minus. Stamkos is now minus one with that goal against.
Moved ahead for Zetterberg. Back to pick it up is Schuster. Stolen here in front. Pinballed off Zetterberg. Grabbed there by Nyquist to the line for Smith, who hops in. Nyquist sends it back Smith's way. It went over his stick, though. And Hedman will just lift a backhander down into the Red Wing zone. Erickson and Datsyuk drawing the helpers on that goal. With that assist, Pavel Datsyuk just one behind Sergei Fedorov for fifth all-time in Red Wing helpers. Fedorov had 554. Pavel has played in 46 fewer games than Fedorov as of this night tonight. So within one of Sergei for fifth. Coming through was Strollman to the line for Barberio. Knocked away when Helm was nearly in alone. Carried back in by Brian Boyle, the big forward, and the ex-Ranger. Right out in front, knocked away. Smith got a piece. He brought it right to the front of the goal, and Stamkos couldn't bury that. Here's Tatar. Turning at the line. Circling.
Look at him battle. Look at him battle.
Still going. Tatar into the slot, came to the line. Bouncing puck, hustling over his Weiss to get it. Tatar and Datsyuk will now head off. Weiss joined by his line mates, Glenn Denning and Riley Sheahan. Puck's at center. Into the wing to Paquette. Blockered aside by Mrazek, but put it right back into the slot for Jonathan Drouin. Drouin lost it at the line. Oh, Red Wings breaking through. And they're going. Glenn Denning gives it to Sheahan. He's in on the low. Saved by Bishop. Woo. Who kept the play alive, or did he? No, he got the whistle.
Wow. Cool hand, Luke. You're hot. But so has Riley Sheahan been hot. That's a great save by Ben Bishop to keep this game at 1-1. Jonathan Drouin, that's why he's only got 11 minutes a night. Coughing it up like that. You're watching Red Wing Hockey. Brought to you by Bell Tire. Sparkling save for sure on Riley Sheehan. A 2-1-0 breakaway. And Jonathan Drouin is not happy that he coughed that up, but I'm wondering where the heck was his defense. In the offensive zone, they just weren't there.
Here's Brendan Smith on the intercept. Turning Yurko. He gets knocked down by Hedman. Hedman, who missed a lot of time early in the season with a fractured finger, missed 18 games. Ouellette was held up there by Killorn. Now a race for the puck as Yurko chases there with Paquette, who got the first goal of this game for Tampa Bay. To the line it comes for DeKeyser, across for Quincy, and tight, but did knock it deep. Schuster against Anderson. Hedman pins Anderson there, then Miller came in to get position on Paquette. Miller comes up with the puck. Miller played it off the back of the net.
Oh, boy.
Only open in front was Ablocator, just couldn't get a stick on it. As the Red Wings are in the midst of a change here. Red Wings with 65 points. Tampa Bay 64 points coming into this one tonight. Tampa lost their last game. The Red Wings have won their last six. Tampa, their past 14, though, has gone 10-4. And only three times in the past 14 games have the Lightning scored fewer than three goals.
Well, we'll take whatever luck we can get from the Tampa feed here. And there's the attempted pass by Drew. And, boy, you have to, he has to learn. And it's Riley Sheehan looking to beat him on the glove side. He's got to get it up high to do that. But what young players like Drouin don't understand is how dangerous it is when you are the last man back there and you got to make sure that you get the puck through somehow.
Media was asking Mike Babcock this morning about Riley Sheehan. His immediate first two words, real player.
No kidding. No kidding.
By the end
That's
of the
easy
year,
for us to, we've been watching him every night.
He's a bona fide second line center
sure
in this
is.
League. Saved by Mrazek, but the rebound came right back off the Filppula attempt.
Well, Shan's another guy that, because of the injuries last year, he probably would have spent the year in Grand Rapids. There's no question about that, but he had to come up. And, I mean, he's just grabbed the reins of opportunity and said, I ain't giving it up. And he's become a very, very, very good hockey player.
Mrazek will hold on. Yeah, Riley played four games, was sent back and recalled mid-January because of the Pavel Datsyuk injury, and he's stuck. Get the Red Wings five-game combo presented by Little Caesars. You'll get tickets to five Wings games, a free hot and ready pizza, Red Wings car flag, and a ticket to the MSU versus Michigan game for as low as $195. Only available until tomorrow because the game's tomorrow night. Call 313-471-7575 now. Ticket executives are standing by.
And just to finish up on Riley Sheehan, he only played a half a year last year, and Riley Sheehan had 9 goals. I mean, that's a 20-goal year.
Helm has got the Red Wing goal tonight. Put one off to the corner and hustled after it, and Datsyuk able to dig it out. And the Lightning will play it. On the wing for Palat. Former seventh-round pick in 2011 and has 36 points in the season. Taken out. Datsyuk tries to get it. Got some help in here from DeKeyser. And then the Red Wings are arguing here that Tampa touched it on the way down. Both Tatar and Datsyuk are they're really questioning the play. And you think at that point, and so is Mike Babcock. He doesn't like it. He says Tampa played it. They weren't intending to ice it. Now Darren Helm continuing the cause, but referee Mark Jonette not buying any of that, nor the linesman. So they're still arguing the case. Pavel Datsyuk saying, hey.
They should go outside the blue line or to center ice if they admit their mistake. So they're saying that Garrison should have played the puck.
Right, because he was tying up the man.
Yeah,
that's the problem with the icing. The Red Wings aren't trying to ice it by any stretch. They're just trying to get it out, and the defenseman's there, throw it up the board. Now, the defenseman's pinching on a Red Wing and chose not to play the puck.
This is interesting that they're confabbing like this.
Yeah. And Callahan, who's been a captain.
Yeah, well, I just read those lips.
Well, Callahan, who's worn the C, used to go in with the officials.
That was pretty good. I like it.
Well, the linesman, John Grant and Derek Amell.
He's not taking any guff.
And the Red Wings are going to win the argument.
They confabbed.
It's going to center.
This is really, really rare that you see this happen, but good for them to get it right. That's what it's all about. The Garrison there on the right-hand side has no intention to play the puck coming up here. He just plays the body in a cross-check, and they're going, hey, wait a minute here.
Right.
It's a pretty obvious play.
John Grant's a younger linesman, number 98. Derek Amell's the veteran, and the Red Wings won their case. And now they're telling him, that doesn't mean you can make another change here. So they get that straightened out. But the Red Wings do get the face-off at center.
Pretty good.
See, sometimes arguing Nick pays.
Sooner or later, well, depends on who you're arguing with.
Right.
You know what I mean? Yeah.
Well, Bishop played it right in front of his own goal.
City Hall, you never win with that.
No.
But you know what? It's all about getting it right. And hey, it doesn't matter who may look bad in the process. The integrity of the game and the rightness and is it what it's all about. And they did there. So four minds are better than one. Good for them.
Brought on here by Glendening. Got the hot stick of late. And that'll be held again from his knees by 6'7" Ben Bishop. Luke Glendening, who had 2 goals on Tuesday night and a beauty and a couple on the forehand, too. Glendening's former team, way back in his college days, well, not all that far back, I guess, the Michigan Wolverines. He said he's going to try to get down to the game with some buddies tomorrow night at Joe Louis Arena, as the Wolverines will take on the Spartans. And if you can't make it down to the Joe tomorrow night, we'll have it for you, 7:30. Darren Elliott will join me here on Fox Sports Detroit for the Wolverines and the Spartans. This will be icing, and the faceoff will come back down ice. And if you're coming down to the Joe tomorrow night to see this game, you'll get to see this man, the Red Wings' 15th overall pick last June. Dylan Larkin leads all Big Ten freshmen, 29 points, 17 points his past 7 games. And the Wolverines on a 7-game winning streak. The Spartans on a 2-game winning streak under Tom Anastas after a sweep last weekend of Ohio State. So it should be a dandy tomorrow night at the Joe. Quincy got one ahead. Abdelkader on to Nyquist. Lost it at the Tampa line, and the Lightning able to recover. Brought back in here by Nikita Kucherov. Left it there, and the shot, a hard one from Andre Palat, missed the target. Tyler Johnson to the near side it comes. And flipped out by Nyquist down the ice. Victor Hedman back to get it, who did not play in the first meeting against Detroit. His head coach, John Cooper, says someday this guy will win the Norris Trophy as best defenseman. That's how good they think he is. This is the last time to play in the period. Drouin gets checked by Ouellette. Killorn with a shot. A piece of that by Mrazek. Wasn't sure where it was, but it went off to the corner.
And the second white jersey down there. There's three Tampa Bay players.
And they've got the puck in check, but out of the crowd. Paquette scores! Oh, what a shot. He's got both.
Wow. Boy, that's a goal that Detroit's not going to be happy giving up. They were outmanned down in the corner, and it just looked like Tampa Bay was hungrier to get the loose puck. I mean, we had 3 guys there at one point, but that's too late when the puck came off the boards, and Paquette, just like Darren Helm, picks what looked like the top corner right underneath the bar. Killorn going to the front. He's covered, yeah. Oh, yeah. Over the glove, under the bar, 2-1, last minute of play, and Detroit basically was out-muscled in the corner on that one. They won't be happy with that.
Well, the rookie Paquette has another goal tonight, the 4th round pick of the Lightning back in 2012. With 10 seconds to go in the period, Tampa shoots it in by Strawman. Put back behind Erickson, too far for Cronwall. Over there to get it, Barbario, as the first period comes to a close. Drouin and Killorn assisting. 19:23, the time of the goal for Tampa Bay. Our Ram intermission report. Thomas Yurko will be in conversation with John Keating. Darren Helm with the goal for the Red Wings. And in the studio tonight, as always, Darren Elliott, Chris Osgood, and Mickey York. Lightning head coach John Cooper's come a long way from being a public defender in Lansing after he graduated from Cooley Law School.
To get to the NHL was not an end game future for myself. I was an attorney at the time, so I wasn't really looking that way, but as I grew with the game and as my career grew, naturally, now your goals start to change, and it's been one hell of a ride. It's been a lot of fun.
And who discovered him was a judge in Lansing and asked him to coach his son's high school team at Catholic Central in Lansing. And the rest, as they say, is history. Although he did say being a public defender and working during jury trials and had to convince juries helps him in the dressing room trying to convince his players. So that was good. And I should correct something I mentioned earlier. It was late March in 2013 that he moved up here to Tampa Bay after Guy Boucher was let go. So he wasn't the head coach when Grand Rapids beat Syracuse. The year before, he was with all these players with the Norfolk Admirals when they won the championship, and then Tampa switched affiliations to Syracuse that summer. But John Cooper, one of the good guys in the game, and Mike Babcock certainly respects how he came along and worked at his craft. It was Kelly Chase and Brett Hull who hired him to coach the St. Louis Bandits after that in the North American Junior Hockey League, and coached there as well and worked his way up. Saved by Mrazek as the second period is underway and he'll hold on.
He would be the true meaning in a good way of a clubhouse lawyer, is what you're saying.
Right on. Very true. And Adams finalists for Coach of the Year last season along with Mike Babcock.
Well, his hair is dark now. I don't know how long it'll stay that way.
And Rick Bonus.
Rick Bonus has been around forever. He's a good guy.
Yeah. And Steve Thomas.
Yeah.
Former Red Wing for a short time. Another assistant coach working with the Lightning. Boy, a lot of former Red Wings here with this Tampa organization with Steve Yzerman, Stacey Roos, Director of Player Development, Pat Verbeek, Assistant GM. Wow. Here comes Hedman. Puck's loose for Abdelkader. Abdelkader, the lead pass for Zetterberg. Zetterberg couldn't backhand it through. Tyler Johnson being hooked by Nyquist on the way back. Johnson carries on. Tampa in the midst of a change, so he'll just shoot it in. Mentioned former Red Wings with the Lightning. It was nice to see Brian Rafalski here before the game. Former Red Wing who went down to see the Red Wings in the room and visit for a little bit. Save made off Datsyuk by Bishop. Comes to Tatar and a shot was blocked.
You know this line wants to make up for the goal that they gave up in the last couple of seconds.
Here's Coppola. Turns inside the line to the point and the shot missed the target from Barbario. Lead pass ahead and Helm just couldn't click with that. They say it went over his stick, and that's why it will be an icing. Well, it's Peter Mrazek's net until Jimmy Howard is healthy, and he's still a week and a half away or so, they think. This morning's skate.
They've been on this whole trip, Gustafson and Jimmy Howard, as well as McCollum and Mrazek, so I don't remember the last time we had four goaltenders on a trip.
Off the draw, the shot, and Mrazek will hold on. And Jonas Gustafsson may find some time in the American Hockey League for conditioning before he's ready to go, but he says he's getting closer. Boy, he's been out a long time with that shoulder injury.
Yeah.
And Jonas Gustafsson this morning working.
Well, he was really good down the stretch last year.
The whole season.
Yeah.
Too. I mean, the Red Wings wouldn't have got in for a 23rd straight season if not for him. But Jimmy Howard being hurt. Here's Glendening. Punched right back out by Bishop. Ouellette able to keep it in. Schuster in there. Glendening couldn't tie him up. Played back by Killorn. Out of harm's way by Tampa to center. Brendan Smith. Sent in by Shea. Glendening moves up. Hedman let it go to Killorn. A neat little pass through the middle to Jonathan Drouin. The speedster coming in. Drouin forced wide by Ouellette. Good defensive play. Two young players now tap off the boards with it out front.
Boy.
Smith struggling to find his feet. He looks hurt.
Blocked the shot.
Yeah, left
that
hand.
That was a really good scoring chance. I don't know if they'll pick it up that way, but as far as I'm concerned, it was.
Here's Paquette. Two-goal shooter. That one went high and over top of the goal.
Ooh.
Strahlman taken to the boards hard by Yurko. Ouellette's got it. Forced and slashed at by Brett Connolly. Former sixth overall pick in 2010 of Tampa. This will be an icing charge against the Red Wings. Look at Thomas Yurko, and our local Toyota dealers brings you the scouting report on him. Through 36 games last season, 8 goals, 7 assists. This year, not quite the goal production, but 10 assists and missed the last 8 games with that lower back issue. But in tonight for Danny Cleary, who's played just 2 of the past 14. Yurko on the fourth line tonight with Anderson and Miller. Draw 1 by Detroit for Ouellette. Ouellette on defense now with Cronwall in the absence of Brendan Smith, who blocked that shot on his last shift. So the Red Wings momentarily, and now Ouellette will go off, and on comes Erickson, because Ouellette couldn't change anyway due to the ice. Back of the net, good steal by Anderson. Look for Miller in front. Brian Boyle. Knocked down, penalty coming.
Detroit for tripping, is it, or Boyle for interference or holding? Looks like Detroit.
Detroit, penalty number 18, 2 minutes for holding.
François Saint-Laurent making the call. Well, Mike Babcock, that's the first penalty the Red Wings have taken tonight. Although Mike has said, though they want to be more aggressive penalty killing, they can't be aggressive because they've taken too many penalties lately. Not much argue for that.
Yeah, I mean, he got knocked off stride. He had his left arm hooked around Boyle. Big Boyle's at 6'7". Another big guy that came from the Rangers, and he's a good penalty killer and a shot blocker.
Well, Tampa's power play that struggled, just 1-for-15 their past 5, has made a switch on it. Callahan's got it. It's Jonathan Drouin, the rookie, playing up on the top unit on the power play. Stamkos is back at the left point. Drouin's got it now. Callahan in the slot with it. Let it go back to the line to Anton Strahlman. They're taking Stamkos away, at least trying to. He's on the left side of your screen, number 91 in the faceoff circle. Quick shot. Boy, does he get it quick. Mrazek got a piece of that.
It's like a mirror image of number 8 in Washington, the same place on the ice. Ovechkin with that bomb of his. Right-hand shot on the left side, and they one-time the heck out of him. Pretty dangerous stuff.
Bishop, good play. Gets it up to Stamkos, who's in and missed it.
Wow.
Great play by the goaltender Bishop to get it ahead to Stamkos. Drouin. Got it to the line, Strahlman. Stamkos scores!
There it is. That was pretty far out, too. And in the feet of Peter Mrazek. I'm not sure he's happy with it.
Seventh goal is past 10 games for the Sniper. Stamkos, his 27th of the season.
Was he screened? Hard to tell on those angles. This might tell us.
That's his 8th power play goal of his 27 that he scored. The first overall pick in 2008. 46 points now for Stamkos on the season. A couple behind Tyler Johnson for the team lead. So that's just Tampa Bay's 2nd power play goal their past 6 games on 16 tries. Mick talked about the Red Wings lack of penalty-killing prowess in our open tonight and the lack of Tampa's power play success. But they're one for one tonight. As the Red Wings have now allowed at least one power play goal in six straight games and nine of their past 11. And trail by two. This Tampa team's much different than Florida. The Red Wings were down to the Panthers 2-1 after one on Tuesday night, but scored four in the second. Here's Nyquist. A shot deflected just off the high glass. Advocator had it go off a skate, deflect in front, as it's moved here to Palat. Right back out by Ouellette. He's back on defense with Smith, who's okay. Brought back in by Tatar. Cuts to the middle, then lost it. Staying with him was Hedman. Lead pass to Drouin. That was rising over the left hand of Mrazek. Tampa delayed there to play it so as not to have too many men on the ice. Backhanded off Drouin and out to center. Ahead for Helm. He's got the Red Wings goal tonight. Blocked by Killorn. Datsyuk trying to get it. He'll go off in a change as Bishop will play it. Hounded by Sheahan. Strahlman for Tampa. Around Ryan Callahan. First captain for captain trade in history when he came over from Marty St. Louis from the Rangers.
2-on-1.
Glendening backhanded. Great play. Strahlman first with the stick and then flicked the glove and got it ahead. Here's Stamkos. Wide to his right. Keeps on going. Stamkos wraparound try in front. Fend it off.
He's got the energy now that he got a goal.
That was fanned on by Nesterov, who flexed his stick thinking the composite might have split on him. He has it at the line and able to keep it in. Callahan couldn't take it away from Sheahan, but then it's intercepted by Nesterov. Callahan threw it around to the far corner. And out at center, Garrison takes it. Tampa caught in the Red Wings zone. And Glendening will send the Lightning back to retrieve it. Bishop for Jason Garrison. This will be icing against the Lightning.
Well, the Red Wings being down by two here, you still got lots of time, 12 minutes and change left in the second period, but they really need to get some jump in their game. A couple of goals that they'd like to have back. That second goal late in the period, can't score coming out of the corner like that. And this third one here, I think, was not screened or deflected. Another look that we can't get because of the camera angles here. We're at the mercy of the home team here, and we get what we get, so I wish I could do better on that, but I can't. And it just looked like it wasn't deflected, and that would mean it was not a good goal for Mrazek to give up. You're watching Red Wing Hockey on Fox Sports Detroit, presented by Bell Tire.
Pavel Datsyuk has an assist tonight. 15 points the last 12 games against the Lightning. Henrik Zetterberg's been on a roll of late the past four with 5 goals and 9 points. Nothing new for the Euro Twins. Combined ranks as teammates since 2002 when Henrik Zetterberg came in that season, 1 year after Pavel Datsyuk. And look what they've done in terms of numbers and NHL rank. Combined in goals, third best. Assists, second best. And all-time points, 1,567 for the two. Our Flagstar Bank Star Watch. Two great stars for the Red Wings. Fun to watch night in and night out. Pavel Datsyuk and Henrik Zetterberg.
They could use them now. Get back in this game. Down by a pair. About half a game to go. Both those guys played about half a season last year. Zetterberg had 16 goals in 45 games. And Datsyuk had 17 in 45 games. So, again.
And nearly both pretty much a point per game pace for the two of them in what was a half a season. And they only played 29 games together last season. And yet the Red Wings still made the playoffs for a 23rd consecutive year. What would be great for the Red Wings is they'd like home ice in the first round, I would think, at least. They have not had...
What's that like?
Not since 2011.
Right. Yeah,
they had...
Been a while.
Home ice in the first round. Right now, this game tonight, a battle for top spot in the Atlantic. The Red Wings came in a point ahead of the Lightning on a six-game winning streak as Detroit Tampa's won their past eight in this building. Off a skate. Oh, they're going to call goaltender interference. As Bishop went down, and the bigger they are, the harder they fall, and Abdelkader was in on top of them.
He's arguing that he got pushed in. There was contact there.
He just read his lips, said he pushed me.
No good.
Yeah. And Bishop sure sold it.
Oh, he certainly did. It could go either way. There's no question about that. Was it Barbario?
Yep.
Couple of number eights. So Red Wings get the smelly end of that stick for sure.
Well, Tampa's 1-for-1 on their power play tonight. Red Wings want to be more aggressive on the penalty kill. Try to improve in that regard. Gave you the numbers, how it slipped lately. And as we've also said, Mick had mentioned the other night, some of that does come down to goaltending. It's, Jimmy Howard had the fifth best save percentage shorthanded in the league when he was injured. And that's where Mrazek will have to come up with some big saves here. Look at Stamkos driving through. Forced wide by Cronwall. Great play. Erickson to Glendening. And forced back by Drouin. A new addition is mentioned to this power play for Tampa Bay. They're looking for some different looks here as Filppula dropped back to Drouin. Callahan in front. Drouin to the point to Stamkos. Back there with Strahlman. Anderson's got it. Out there now with Drew Miller. Anderson first on it. Filppula put it in behind for Callahan to Drouin. Pestered there by DeKeyser. Nailed in by Garrison. He's got that shot. Have to be wary of him. Filppula sent it in down low. Red Wings in the box formation. Stamkos didn't one time it. Passed in front. Sheahan got a piece of it. Garrison kept it into Stamkos. Back to Garrison. Save Mrazek. Quincy. Ooh, did he get hit hard? Oh, Kyle Quincy was off balance. They finished the check.
A dirty hit.
The center ice referee has called it. The referee down low did not. And yes, the Red Wings should take exception to that one. Francois Saint-Laurent made the call. Marc Jonette, I'm not sure he was looking right at it or not, but he didn't make a call, and Quincy got nailed.
He's got a sore shoulder from that one.
Remember, Quincy put the big hit on Brown earlier in the game.
Right. Well, the difference in the hits is that Brown wasn't vulnerable, but Quincy was. He's shooting the puck. He gets hit from the blind side.
Oh, Jonette didn't see it. That's why he didn't call it down.
Right. Yep. You're completely defenseless on a hit like that. And by the look of that replay, Callahan could have hit him worse. And he thinks it's a joke, obviously. So,
well, Quincy's laughing too, and that's a good thing.
It's a joke for everybody, okay?
Yeah, okay.
It's a tough game.
Right on. So the Red Wings here with some 4-on-4 hockey. And the Advocator's time remaining winding down on his penalty that you see there. Hedman couldn't get through. So a little more room out here for the time being as Barbario brought it in, and Tyler Johnson made a move down low for the Tampa defenseman Barbario. Puck stripped away as Helm kicked it. Smith's stick is broken.
Ooh, that looked outside.
Now he gets one from Helm. DeKeyser turning, Abdelkader out of the box, so the Red Wings now on a belt tire power play, their second, and then a broken stick there from Hedman. Datsyuk got Hedman without his stick. That's scary. Abdelkader shooting, but easy save for Bishop.
No kidding.
Make.
I thought Pavel was going to take advantage of that and absolutely turn him inside out, leave his jockstrap off the clock. Oh, boy. Well, Red Wings will get some short power play time, minute 18. To be exact, busted stick there. And Datsyuk decided to go to Abdelkader, and Ben Bishop made it look easy.
Well, the Red Wings on their second Bell Tire power play. They were 0-for-1 against Florida on Tuesday. In the first meeting with the Lightning, they were 2-for-4 in that game, a game Tampa won in the shootout, and the guy in the box right now had the game-deciding goal that night, Brian Callahan, who also had two assists. That game was at the Joe. These two teams will meet two more times next month, or in March. Paquette scores! Patrick Paquette! The first of his career! And a shorthanded goal at that!
Well, Brian Boyle was brought over from the New York Rangers to be a penalty killer and a face-off guy. He wins the face-off right here from Zetterberg down low to the left of Bishop, and everything went downhill for Detroit from there. Paquette, it's wrestled for right here on the corner. They got to him too quickly, and it's Boyle. The puck's turned over, and bang, they're gone. 2-on-1. Cronwell tries to take the pass away, and no mistake for Paquette to make it 4-1. Boy.
First career hat trick for Cedric Paquette. He began the night with 6 goals. He's got 9. Previous best was a 2-goal game back in November against Calgary.
Well, there's a lot of Red Wing jerseys in this building. I'd say at least half full, and they are sitting on their seats and on their hands. They got nothing to cheer about so far here tonight.
The lower bowl is practically all red and white.
Yeah, it sure is. And behind Peter Mrazek, there's a ton of Red Wing jerseys. Look at them all back up there. But it's all Tampa Bay here with a half a game left to play. A tall order for the Red Wings to climb back into this game. But they're on the power play. I'd say they need one right now to even begin that climb back into the game.
And Tampa is the top scoring offense in the NHL. Datsyuk getting it back here for DeKaiser. Back for Pavel Datsyuk. Tatar. Into Sheahan, knocked off his stick, and the Lightning are away. Killorn, Tatar trying to get back. Killorn drives the goal. And ran out of real estate as he was pressured. Good play by DeKaiser.
Right now Tampa Bay just quicker. They're quicker on the puck, and they're forcing Detroit to make plays that they don't want to make. And as a result, you got a bunch of turnovers.
Tampa Bay with 160 goals for now to lead the NHL.
See, there's the reach of the goaltender right there that allowed him to get that puck. That's amazing.
Turning to Tatar. Cronwall to Tatar. Takes the shot. Helm. Penalty over. Callahan out of the box. As the Lightning head up ice. Paquette. He's having a career tonight. He was dumped by his number 13 counterpart, Datsyuk.
Yeah, he just slashed Datsyuk on the ankle. Datsyuk said, enough of your garbage. Tried to give him a whack.
Henrik Zetterberg brings it in. That was knocked away. Tampa's won 8 straight at home. And lead the league in regulation or overtime wins with 28. Well, the Red Wings came in a point ahead of Tampa Bay. The Lightning with 2 more victories on the season. Behind into the corner here for Nyquist.
Watch Gabriel Cater and Garrison. They're going at it. They're going at it. They're going at it. You can see it coming.
There they go.
There he goes. Abbey took him. He got hit by him in the corner. And there he goes. Gabriel Cater didn't like the way he got hit again in a vulnerable position. And I could see his body language was going after him. Enough of this crap. We're down 4-1. You guys have had enough. And I'm coming back at you. Maybe that'll get them fired up. 4-1 for the home team. We'll be back in a moment. Well, Abdicator was telling the referee while we were away, they were all around the box, about the cross check that he took from Garrison. Didn't like it because it was over the elbow pad. and underneath the protection of the shoulder pad, right on bone. And he didn't like it, and you could tell right away he was going back at Garrison. And although Garrison got a couple in early, Cavalcator came back with a nice haymaking right that they both put down on there. So who knows? The crowd liked it. Let's see if the bench reacts to it on the Red Wings side. They're down by three.
Ouellette got bumped as Miller's there. Ouellette pulled it back in, checked by Boyle. Boyle, a big body at 6'7", 244 pounds, is number 11.
I'm surprised the Rangers let him go, you know. He was a key part of that team going to the finals last year.
Former first-round pick of Los Angeles back in 03.
Yeah. Apparently his wife is from Florida, and he wanted to come down here, and the Rangers didn't want to sign him for the money he was looking for. That's all she wrote.
All she wrote, literally.
Hey, that's what I said. That's all she wrote. All right. She's writing the checks.
Yeah. Exactly.
Yeah.
Played up here for Nesterov. Stamkos. Ouellette played it. Callahan. Philpla can't get through, and here come the Red Wings. The lead pass in for Sheahan. Sheahan turns in the faceoff dot. Took the shot that was going wide. Bishop plays it and calmly gives it to Valtteri Philpla. He scored 100 goals and 251 points as a member of the Red Wings. Played just shy of 500 games with Detroit. Did Philpla, who's on his way now, and goes after it with Quincy and lifts his stick. Philpla got it through into the corner here for Stamkos. Stamkos came up front with it. Getting over there to pick it up was Glendening, got it to center. Weiss.
Oh,
and nearly pulling a groin to stay on side was Quincy, but it did not work.
A rough period for Quincy.
Well, the Islanders came into this game tied with the Red Wings for top spot in the East. Highlights of their game with Boston next. In terms of Boston's coming for sure.
Well, Boston's been awfully good lately. They get their injuries back. Victoria's back now, settled in.
And remember, the Red Wings get the Islanders 2 o'clock. That's going to be a packed house at Joe Louis Arena on Saturday afternoon. The New York Islanders and the Red Wings.
Well, what's interesting is we'll have these same two teams, Tampa Bay and the Islanders, in a month in reverse. We get to Tampa Bay at home and then turn around and go into the island the next day. So, take another look there. And you see, Boston and the Rangers. Now, you're looking at wild card teams down here. And Toronto, who struggled lately, got a point last night in an overtime or a shootout loss.
They're done, Mick.
You think so?
They're done. They're done.
Take a fork in them? You think?
Here's Nyquist.
But anyway, the Red Wings, you know, they've surprised a lot of people by being where they are and the points they've got. But, you know, this job is not over. There's a lot of work to do yet with a lot of games left. So you don't want to take your foot off the gas at any point in time. And the Islanders will be hot to trot Saturday afternoon. I'll guarantee you that at 2 o'clock.
Oh, for sure. Well, Peter Mrazek's won 5 consecutive games since taking over for Jimmy Howard. Remember, he was pulled in the win over Buffalo, didn't finish that one. But now with the 4 goals against him tonight, even though he's won 5 straight, he's allowed 20 goals the last 6.
Well, his savior has been that the team's been scoring a lot of goals.
Yes.
So, you know, that's not always going to happen.
Red Wings have now allowed 4 goals each of their past 4 games, but they won the previous 3.
Well, the one thing that they've been, their penalty killing has been very, very good. They've been at top of the league all year long. 5-on-5, they're not bad, but they're a long way from the best. And the power play has been okay. Tough start, but they got her going lately. And so when you put all that together, the reason they've got the points they've got is because of goaltending and defense. They have really been good in those areas. But as you point out, that is slipping as of late.
Red Wings came into the game tonight 6th best in the NHL defensively. Conversely, Tampa Bay 15th. Their special teams middle of the pack. But Tampa wins by offense because they lead the league in goals.
Right.
They're 8 straight home wins for the Lightning, one shy of what would be a club record 9th straight. So the Red Wings need a miraculous third period to prevent that from happening.
Well, at this point in time, with only 3:33 to go in the second, Detroit would be ultra happy to find a way to get a point out of here.
Do you think we see Thomas McCollum to start the third?
Possibly. Yep, very possibly.
These Lightning aren't your Sabres, however. You need something to shake up the group.
That's right.
Knocked down before it got through to Mrazek.
I'll let that go.
And Bishop was out to play it. He enjoys that part of the game. It's like a great goaltender who retired today, Marty Brodeur. Brendan Smith. Yurko got a piece of it. Hedman back to get it. Forced there by Nyquist. Victor Hedman lifted one back into Detroit territory. Ouellette is there. He'll chase it and get there, so no icing. Smith moved it quickly. But Nyquist couldn't corral it, and now that will be icing against Detroit.
Well, the Red Wing fans are trying to scoop it up here, but not too high.
Well, the college hockey rivalry returns to the Joe tomorrow night. MSU, Michigan, dual on the D, tickets, and believe me, there are very few remaining. Start at $15. Little Caesars family four-pack start at $44. Get yours now, 313-471-7575. Ticket executives are standing by. This game very close to a sellout.
We'll all
tomorrow
be there,
night
Marty.
At the Joe, yeah. I know Ken Holland's going to be there for sure to watch Dylan Larkin. So the Spartans and the Wolverines, get your tickets quickly because this is pretty much a sellout.
Imagine that, 20,000 people in Joe Louis Arena for those youngsters in college.
Scores right off the draw. Barbario gets his first.
Now, Tampa Bay weren't very good in the faceoffs in the first period with only 44%, but two clean face-off wins here tonight in the second period have resulted directly in goals.
Well, with a 5-1 score now, I would think you'd see McCollum to start the third, but we'll see. That's his sixth career goal for the defenseman.
Now, Mike Babcock has gone down to that end of the bench, and he's talking. Is it Riley Sheehan? I can't tell. No, it's Yurko right off the face-off, so you know what's being said there. A little tap, like, come on, kid. So
it's all about learning, right?
Teaching, and, teaching right there, yeah.
So the Red Wings have surrendered 5 tonight. We're searching for a 7th consecutive win. Tampa Bay took the first meeting in a shootout, and as Mick spoke of, they'll meet two more times in March. Once more here and once at the Joe. Schuster and Johnson getting the assists. 17:39, the time of Barbario's goal. Back there is Nesterov. Glendening tries to get it, but the three-goal shooter for the Lightning, Cedric Paquette, gets it in, his first career hat-trick. Darren Helm is a lone Red Wing goal from Erickson and Datsyuk that tied the game at 1 in the first period.
Well, the Red Wings haven't had this kind of an outing in a long time. Down 5-1 after 40 minutes. Boy.
Going there to pick it up is Helm. Right in front of Owen Bishop. Geez. Good save on Tatar.
Look what I got. Oh, my God. He hit it. I don't know that he moved on this. We'll take a look at it. Tatar got to shake his head and go, you got to be kidding me. A bullet wrist shot. Did he move? Let's see. He did. He did some. That's a great pickup by a goaltender. With a guy that close to him, hash marks, and he rips it. Holy jumping. But it was in his wheelhouse. Great shot, great save.
Well, Bishop's numbers against the Red Wings have been superb. 5-1 against Detroit. with a 935 save percentage in his career. Bishop making a sixth straight start tonight and a 10th consecutive appearance. Loose again, and Bishop will come out and play it over. Intercepted by Tatar. Tatar's right in, and a diving play made by Schuster. And he's got that long reach, too. He's up near Chera territory.
That's the second play that they've made defensively in this period to save a AAA scoring chance.
6'8 defenseman.
The key there for Garrison is to try to make a play if you can without taking a penalty. But he got some help.
So, final minute of period number two. A scary notion for Detroit going into the third. The Tampa's the best third period team in the league, scoring 59 goals.
Yeah, look out, here they are again.
Knocked away as Weiss got it over here to Abdelkader. And this will result in some mixing up of lines here tonight, and the Red Wings in the position they are right now. Palat carries. Laid out at center for Weiss. Hedman circles, and a great period for the Lightning, who led by one after one and lead by four after two. And here's what's coming your way in our MGM Grand Detroit second intermission report. Steven Stamkos with a power play goal tonight. And our powers in the studio, Chris Osgood, Darren Elliott, and Mickey York. Well, a new goaltender for the Red Wings, as we thought would be after Peter Mrazek allowed 5 on 15. Yes, Thomas McCullum will come in to take over. He came on for Mrazek in the what resulted in a win for him, his first against Buffalo. After Mrazek was pulled that night, and the Red Wings beat the Buffalo Sabres by a final count of 6-4. The Red Wings have been scoring a lot lately, but tonight have been have allowed 5 for the second time this season. Stay tuned to Red Wings Live following the game, where we'll select the Fox Sports Detroit Red Wings player of the game, presented by single, double, and triple cheeseburgers from McDonald's. Well, Darren Helm scored the beautiful goal tonight. That's all the Red Wings have been happy about. But Peter Mrazek is now, he had won 5 straight, but in his last 6 games now has allowed 21 goals. Well, he'd won 6 without any loss because McCullum got the win, so Mrazek had a no decision. Well, unless the Red Wings have a miracle third period here, both their winning streak and Peter Mrazek's will come to a conclusion. Tampa Bay looking for a 9th straight home win, which would be a franchise record.
Tough league.
Yes, it is.
That's what happens, boy, with young players. I don't care if it's a goalie or not.
Save made by McCullum as he's tested right away by Kucherov. And that's up and out of play, deflected off the netting.
Well, Thomas McCollum's in, and how anxious was he to get into the net? When he came out, he took a little stumble. He toe-picked right out of the gate. God bless you, kiddo. Can't wait to get on the ice. Pick yourself up by your bootstraps and get at it. And he had to make a really good save right off the hop. That's the boy. Good job.
Drouin took a shot, was blocked by DeKeyser. Came back to Drouin again. Danny DeKeyser was hoping to play tonight against Luke Witkowski, who was his defense partner at Western Michigan for 3 years, a draft choice at Tampa. But John Cooper elected not to play Witkowski tonight. DeKeyser was hoping he would be able to oppose him this evening. Would have been cool for him. They were a good duo with the Broncos.
Well, that's one of the reasons that the big defenseman Nesterov is in, and he was standing still on the only goal by Darren Helm. So that and the injury to Gudas, their real tough right-handed shooting defenseman number 7, who's out for a long time.
Filppula carries in. Stamkos with a good play. Callahan got it back to the line. Schuster across to Victor Hedman. Tipped in front. Off Stamkos' stick and just wide. Back to the line for Schuster. To Victor Hedman. Knocked away by Quincy. He'll join the rush here. Can the Red Wings get an odd man? Look at Stamkos hustling back with Quincy. High slot and again an easy save. As Zetterberg put one through. Shots were 15 apiece after 40 minutes of play in this game. Our Southgate Lincoln fun fact, Pavel Datsyuk, who tied Ted Lindsay for 11th on the all-time franchise list tonight in games played. I know Ted loves watching Pavel play.
Who doesn't, eh?
Yep.
But tonight, not in the cards for Pavel and his boys. He's got two shots on goal. Red Wings have 15. It's been not much from either side, really.
No, Tampa doesn't have much more than that now. They have 15 after 40 minutes as well, because theirs were going in. And that, too, as much as anything else in the way they went in and the late in the period, that can be deflated. For sure.
I'd say three of your five goals are questionable.
Yep. So even Stamkos, who can wire it, but... And Peter Mrazek may be the first to tell you that same thing. Spot off, chuckled, and McCollum will hold on.
Well, opportunities like this with McCollum in goal can only help young players, no matter where they go, where they end up, whether the Red Wings are deep in goaltending over the years, and McCollum moved on. He's getting playing time at the best league in the world, and they're a little bit of a juggling act. Keep that rebound for a faceoff. You look back.
And that'll be held.
You look back. This is anybody's game at the end of the first period. It's a 1-1 game, and that goal came out of nowhere. As you look at Mr. Bowman along with Danny Belisle on Scotty's right. Danny was a longtime scout for the Red Wings. He's now retired, living down in the area. And Scotty, of course, lives in this area, comes to all these games, along with Jimmy DeVellano, who's here tonight sitting somewhere else. He's here at every home game for the Tampa Bay team. As he moves up and back. Detroit to Tampa. And Scotty's all over the place, helping his son in Chicago.
There's a shot just rifled wide off Jonathan Drouin's stick.
And Scotty had time to go down and visit with Mike Babcock and the boys before the game. The coaches.
Drouin coughed it up to Glenn Denning. Drouin broke his right thumb during training camp at the start of this season. Last year with the Halifax and Junior, the Quebec League, he had 108 points in 46 games. Last year of junior hockey.
Well, it's not an easy transition to make, as we've seen with a lot of players before. He's a highly talented player, and he's being brought along very, very carefully by the Lightning. They're almost hiding him in their lineup at times. He hasn't played every game. That's the injury to speak of. And just because you've scored a million goals in junior doesn't mean that you're going to make it in the pros the same way. A lot haven't.
Boy, and a score like that, and a guy like Drouin's playing third line, you'd think at some point you'd give him some try with Stamkos, wouldn't you?
Yeah, if you can afford to. I mean, it's all about winning for these coaches on a daily basis. Boy, they don't want to take any chances with anybody. But, I mean, our guy Mantha is going to go through the same thing about trying to adjust to, you know, pro hockey, whether it's the American League or the National Hockey League. Boy, it's a whole different kettle of fish.
Yep. Kucherov. It'll roll back into the Red Wing zone.
Look out.
Oh, and a good save there by McCullough.
Right in the mouth. Hit him right in the face. On a terrible, terrible giveaway. Boy.
Helm trying to get in, couldn't. And Schuster will get it ahead for Palat. To an open wing to Kaiser, backing up to pick it up. Carried through by Helm. Kucherov came back on him. can see why Kucherov leads the league at plus 27.
Yeah.
Always hustling back defensively. And a good play there to negate the rush by Helm.
Well, a moment ago, you had the big defenseman Hedman knock Helm out of the way.
Tonight on Fox Sports Live, full Super Bowl coverage, plus Marshawn Lynch finally speaks his mind. Following a tough loss to Notre Dame, Coach K releases one of his players. And details from Tiger Woods' first round of 2015 in Phoenix. Now, if you played like garbage at the Phoenix Waste Management Open, would that be considered par for the course?
I like it.
Yeah.
I'd say. Yeah.
Okay. Not that he did.
Par for the course. Well, I think they'd be looking for a little more than par for the course. Under par for the course. Yeah.
Phoenix Waste Management Open.
Tiger said he's hitting it as far as he was 15 years ago.
How about that? Swings a lot faster, he said,
Change it again.
Where those who don't play the game well just swing faster than they shouldn't be, right?
But good luck with that.
Tiger's fast swing is different. Over there to Boyle. Mishandled, but the Kaisers got it, giving it back for Ouellette. Brendan Smith. He'll go in after it. There's Miller, Weiss, and Anderson.
You're down 5-1. Why not?
Yeah.
Smith's in playing forward.
We'll see some different machinations here in the third period for the Red Wings. As JT Brown lifted ahead to center, but on... Oh, it looked offside. Colin...
Well, it was, except he had control, and you are allowed.
I didn't think he had control. No. Brett Connolly...
Linesman looked at it.
Here's Brown. They're usually right. Weiss.
Tampa put it out to center. Tampa can just put this baby to bed. I mean.
Here's Brown on the wing. Played it back. Shot blocked and the bouncing puck. Block in search of another one. Marquette's up there. He'll go off. He's got three goals. Xavier Ouellette for Cronwall. Now Erickson comes over the boards to join Cronwall, who gives it off to Yurko. Kucherov dropped it back. Palat. Shot was blocked. Glendening couldn't get through Schuster. Hedman back to get it. Schuster delayed at the line and it's tipped through. Tyler Johnson out there for Tampa Bay. He's got an assist tonight to lead to his team leading numbers. 49 points in the season for him now. DeKaiser intercepted. Here's Helm with Datsyuk and Tatar. Helm delays at the line. He's got the Red Wing Golden Knight. Gives it for DeKaiser off a stick. Came loose. Helm able to retrieve it. Back here for Quincy. Sent to the goal and just wide. Helm to the line. DeKaiser slap shot. Bishop's not sure, but it's underneath him. So Bishop holds on. We'll step out for a moment, and we come back. The winningest goaltender of all time announced his retirement today.
It would have been nice to be at 700, but again, you know, it is what it is. You know, I wish I could have played more games. It's all these lockouts. I got killed on it.
He's right about that. But 804 career wins, including playoffs, so that's not too shabby. Brett Hall, Al MacInnis, Bernie Federko. A Hall of Fame crowd surrounding Marty Brodeur, who's a first ballot Hall of Famer. No doubt he's going to work in the Blues front office. And interesting in his announcement today, Mick, he only mentioned New Jersey in passing, thanks to the New Jersey Devils. That was it. So obviously he thought it could have been handled differently. At the end, he wanted to continue playing. So he'll work at the Blues front office. Lou Lamoriello has said he's welcome back anytime. I'm not so sure that's going to happen.
Well, tough business, and not everybody's happy all the time.
DeKaiser got in front of Kucherov. Here's Tyler Johnson bringing it in.
Boy, after all the hoopla for him, has he been quiet tonight?
Johnson?
Ooh, yeah. Yeah. Really?
You know, this line pretty much leading the National Hockey League in plus-minus. They're plus 75. Save by McCollum was a good one. Plus 75 is this line, Mick. And you think about it, in one season, Bobby Orr was plus 124. In one season, one man, he was 124. Good save there as McCollum knocked away a Johnson shot. And that one just went wide as Palat hit the try.
Those were those great Bruin teams led by Phil Esposito, who's here tonight up in the press box.
Save there on Palat. Another save by McCollum.
Oh, boy.
He's keeping it almost respectable here.
Yeah, right about now, the Red Wings, I think, would be happy to get the heck out of here.
I think so. Get ready for the Islanders on Saturday afternoon. The Islanders lost to Boston 4-2 tonight. Well, they'll remain tied with the Red Wings. Our 5-2 final tonight. Drew Miller got in there to try to kick it back. And then Paquette on the third try got it to center. Paquette's goal right now stands out as the winner unless the Red Wings get something going here. As he got the second goal in this game. McCollum will hold on. He's got three on the night. And speaking of the New York Islanders, here's a look at their mark despite losing to Boston 5-2 tonight. But look what they've managed to do this season. Saturday, Red Wings are home to them. Our coverage begins with Red Wings Live at 1:30. The Red Wings and the Islanders. So Tampa Bay, if they continue to hold on here, will take over top spot in the East. One up on Detroit.
You say if.
Okay, well, you know, it's never. Hey,
I know.
Yogi.
I know.
It's never over till it's over.
I know.
Still got a half a period to go. You think it is, but save McCollum. Look at the way he's playing, man.
Yeah. By the way, the Islanders outshot Detroit badly in that game back in the 19th.
They won 2-1.
They won 2-1.
The Islanders did that night.
32-18 in Joe Louis. So Tampa Bay keeping their foot on the gas, and Thomas McCollum acrobatically making saves like that, back-to-back. Good for the kids' confidence. Another one there. Rebound again. Tampa Bay pushing hard to get number six and throw a little salt in the wound of the Red Wings, who, after giving up that second goal with seconds left in the first period, that seemed to break their back. And every time that you turned around, the puck was going in the net after that.
37 seconds left in the first, and Marquette scored.
Yep. Stamkos goal, questionable. And then a shorthanded. I mean, it's just been downhill after that. So what you get is a 5-1 Red Wing deficit. And if you're a Red Wing fan, it ain't much fun to watch tonight.
10-3 Tampa, the shots here in the third. So the only good news, and confidence-wise, for Thomas McCollum, has played pretty well. So that stumble out of the gate didn't hurt him.
Yeah, exactly.
That may become a routine if he keeps playing
nervous,
like this.
Nervous energy.
Here's Miller trying to fight through.
Could be a penalty there. Nothing. Probably doesn't matter anyway, except for Drew Miller. What are you doing?
Yep. Kicked along.
This may go down. In spite of the fact that the Red Wings had plenty of chances in this game, again, it's a circumstantial game. It'll go down as one of their worst on the scoreboard tonight, this year. But
here's Ouellette with a shot that went wide. You know, although the Red Wings came in sixth defensively, they've allowed too many goals lately, but they were coming up with wins of late, but not tonight. Four had been the norm of late, giving up, but the Red Wings in victorious fashion, and rendering five tonight as Tatar comes in, takes a shot that was sent wide of the goal.
Well, you know you can't go to that well that many times and get away with it. For a while, it's okay, but not against a team like Tampa that can score the way they can.
And looking for another Stamkos, circling the goal. December 29th, the Red Wings allowed five in a 5-2 loss in Boston. That's just the second time this year they've surrendered five. Carr put it back to the point. Helm in there to get it. Helm back of the net. Trying to come out front like he scored his first goal of this game. The only goal for the Red Wings. Tatar. He was robbed by Bishop in the second. Datsyuk trying to fight through. Got body position. Tatar was there. Helm and Schuster. Helm came up with it. Good work. Off the side of the goal. Datsyuk out of the air. It's still loose. The net came off, but not right off the moorings. Just came up top. Tatar in to get it. Some pressure here by Detroit. Cronwall shot. That was handled. Hedman for Tampa Bay. Finally just relieves the pressure. A little burst there by Detroit. Only four shots in the period for the Red Wings. 10 for Tampa Bay. Looking for another. And Palat was hit by Quincy Nyquist. Johnson able to stop him. Turning, Palat back to the line. Barbario. And McCollum's there again. It's a four-goal deficit. Late stages, third period.
5-1 Tampa. Let's take a look at tonight's Chamberlain save of the game. Brought to you by Chamberlain Door. And it's Big Ben Bishop on Thomas Tatar. A bullet drive in the second period that, boy, oh, boy, what a great save that was. He hasn't had to make a ton of them. Riley Shane's breakaway as well. But it's all brought to you by Chamberlain.
And I do have that Chamberlain app on my phone for the garage door. It's pretty cool.
You want to open that app and not close it.
No, you can do both with it. You can do both.
You better in this weather back home.
Very cool. Batted out of the air by Smith. Yurko gave him the puck back. Yurko. Coming back from that lower back issue he's had. Good for him to get a game going.
Yeah, it's been a rough road for Thomas Yurko. We pointed out a good half year last year, and boy, this year's different story with injury and what have you.
Yurko made a play there, set it in front. Oh, a good try for Anderson. Set up by Miller. Man with the hat trick.
Oh, nice slash
Marquette
in the back.
Marquette couldn't
of the leg
get through.
Down.
Yeah.
It's amazing what they don't call sometimes, eh?
Mm-hmm.
Goodness gracious. Tell ya. And it's amazing what they do call other times.
You think?
Oh, my gosh.
Here's Quincy.
Yeah.
In the Tampa territory. Quincy threw it in front. Weiss with it. Back for Quincy. And that's deflected out of play. Only one day remains to get the Fox Sports Detroit College Hockey Hat Pack for tomorrow night's Duel in the D, MSU and Michigan. $25, you'll get a ticket to the game and a Red Wings hat in your school's colors. Go to olympiaentertainment.com/hatpack now to purchase.
That last good chance by Anderson. They haven't had a ton of them tonight, Detroit, but when you get goals going in the way they have against them, it's a hard game to play.
Stamkos pulled it back.
Oh,
nice another
save
nice
again.
Save by McCollum.
This guy is never feeling it after that goal of his. Icing coming for Detroit right here. He really got the energy after the 3-1 goal that really put the two-goal advantage for Tampa Bay. And Stamkos gets the energy and he's a goal scorer like he is, boy, look out. Nice move there. Play the puck, not the body, and that's McCollum bails him out.
And since Stamkos' second season, 09-10, no player in the league has scored more goals than him. 237 now with the goal tonight for Stamkos. Remember, he didn't play much his rookie season.
Right.
Barry Melrose didn't coach much that season. No. He was let go. Rick Tocchet took over.
And he missed half a season last year, or the year before with that broken leg. We got something going on here. frustration, you think? So Ben Bishop makes the save, gets the whistle, a little bit of rough stuff, and we'll be back after this. 5:31 to go. Thanks, Mickey. Yeah, that Pacioretty scored some big goals for Montreal. They continue to win on the road. Let's take a look at our big boy play of the game. And it was a beauty by Darren Helm. Maybe the prettiest goal of the night. Come in behind the net as Ben Bishop was swimming on that frozen pond with those big pads of his. And Helm just worked his way to the front. Everybody stood still. And bingo right in the top of the net. Our big boy play of the game. And with me, an opportunity to send out a great big hello to everybody up in Marquette General Hospital, especially the intensive care unit. All great work that those folks do all over the world in intensive care. They don't get a lot of credit, but the Marquette, a lot of good Red Wing fans up there. And hello to you guys. Stay warm. And thanks for your great work. Wish we had a better show for you tonight. But it's a hockey game, and it'll be a long season with ups and downs.
I think the show's been okay. The score hasn't been. Let's be clear on that, will
I? It's like hospital work. You have your ups and downs.
Here's Nyquist. Backhands one that Bishop will hold.
And time now for our Nissan. We get all our business in here now. 5-1 for the home team. Our Nissan Drive to the Net brought to you by Nissan. It'll be Paquette. Right out of the hop. Nice. No penalty call against Sheahan early in the game. Paquette on his own rebound, up and over Mrazek for his first of three. Our Nissan drive to the net.
First career hat-trick for him. And a 5-1 lead, and Tampa's going to lead the NHL with their 29th regulation or overtime win. They lead the league in goals. And they're going to lead the Eastern Conference by a point over Detroit and the Islanders. And the Red Wings and Islanders, 2 o'clock at the Joe on Saturday afternoon.
Just a kid, Paquette, 21 years old. Quite a night for him. You mentioned his first tour de chapeau in the National Hockey League. That's pretty good stuff.
Here comes Drew Miller. The shot that sailed off a stick and wide. This will also be Tampa Bay's 20th home victory to lead the National Hockey League. And their ninth straight home win, which is a franchise record. The Red Wings' six-game victory streak will stop tonight. Loose here for Weiss. And held on to by Bishop, who made the save.
Well, the Red Wings have yet to lose two straight games in regulation. And everybody else has this year.
But has Nashville yet?
Over the years. I think they did. I'm not, you know, they for the longest time they didn't. But there's been very few teams in the history of the NHL that have on this kind of time, almost 50 games into a season, without losing two games in a row. We'll check that Nashville stuff, but they've been really good right off the hop.
They're at St. Louis tonight are the Predators. No, Red Wings and Nashville. Nashville's not okay. Lost two in a row in regulation. Yeah. So they're the only two teams in the league that have not.
Pretty good stuff.
Yeah.
Probably the only two teams in a long, long time in the history of the NHL that have not done that. Of course, you know, not many years ago, there was no three-point game and the shootout and all that stuff. Even overtime, for that matter.
You would have loved to have gone in the shootout, wouldn't you?
No, you know, not particularly. I did it one time. In the World Tournament for Old-Timers over in, where the heck were we, in France, in Nice, France.
Datsuk, oh, good save there.
And I clanked it off the goalpost square.
Here's Stamkos.
Didn't like it.
Was the goalie wearing a mask at the time?
Oh, yeah, he was. I didn't go
for
his head.
I'm surprised you didn't clank it right off his head. That's what I was thinking.
Because that's a softener-upper. And the next time you go, when he's going up with the pads, you get it down low. But I didn't have that opportunity in a shootout. But I'm a shooter. I wasn't much of a deker, so too many things can go wrong.
Later in life, you've been a deker. Here's Johnson.
Yeah.
Fired in by Nyquist. Bishop corrals it and plays it. Stick in the lane there by Abdelkader. Sent the rest of the way, though, by Tyler Johnson, their leading scorer. Abdelkader couldn't find the handle. Kucherov down low. Johnson tipped. McCollum saved. Oh, another stop. Oh. I'll tell you, what a third period this has been for Thomas McCollum.
No kidding. Got to be huge for his confidence. Now it's either unofficially 14 or 15 shots for Tampa Bay here in the third. That's two right there. Now there it is. They finally put it up there, 30. So, wow. And a lot of them have been grade A scoring chances.
He stopped just all 15 he's faced.
Wow. Well, I'll guarantee you what he's saying. And it may be a long shot. He's saying that if I can show this coach enough here, just maybe I'll get a start. You never know. That's what dreams are made of, boy.
Yeah. Red Wings still, though, hoping that Jimmy Howard will be back on the father's mentor's trip for the games Phoenix to Colorado. Maybe one of those at the end of that trip. So another week or so.
Schedule's not that bad. You've been home Saturday afternoon against the Islanders and then 4 days off before Colorado and Phoenix. And then a few more days off. And even though there's a lot of road games in February, only two home games, Montreal on the 16th and Winnipeg on the 14th. I understand there's not many tickets, if any, left for those either.
No.
So few home games that everybody wants to get there.
And again, not many tickets left for tomorrow night's game either at the Joe. The Spartans and Wolverines.
Looking forward to that.
Yeah, and if you can't join us for that one and see Dylan Larkin, the Red Wings' 15th overall pick from last June, who's having an outstanding freshman year, the Red Berenson, join us. We'll have the game for you on Fox Sports Detroit. Saved by McCollum again. The game coming your way tomorrow night, 7:30, and then the Islanders, 1:30, Red Wings live Saturday afternoon.
So if I go down there, I'm going to miss you. You'll be working the game.
Well, you'll
be down. I'll see
you'll
you
go
down
to
there.
A suite.
I'll be going
turn
there.
Turn on the volume.
There you
and,
go.
You know.
Yeah.
Kenny Holland will be there. Mike Babcock will be there. The Red Wing scouts for sure. And take that one in.
I love
along with 20,000
yeah.
or so.
Those kids got to be excited. I'll bet they're watching this game tonight. They're not already in curfew in bed.
They're curfew?
Getting ready to play tomorrow.
Curfew? What year is this?
Is there a curfew in college?
No.
Well, there was in my day. Although I never got there, but
I know you did.
Nonetheless.
Like the guy who's sitting not far from us, Bowman, would put a stick with the bellman after 11 o'clock and get players to sign it coming in so he'd know who was late. Oh, those days. Now the players
no
have all
kidding.
Caught on. They're just on their best behavior now. Do what you need to do
I
to be a
so.
Pro. Yep.
It's a different world, for sure.
So the Lightning regain top spot in the East. And Saturday, the Islanders and the Red Wings will go at it to try to stay with them and overtake. 5-1 final. The Lightning have won a franchise record 9 straight at home and a great third period for that man, Thomas McCollum. Good job. 17 saves for him.
And he's getting lots of taps from his teammates there. Don't think they didn't notice because they really couldn't get it going and Tampa Bay kept their foot on the gas. So
and Thomas McCollum, Mick, a family member passed away. And
God bless him.
Last
good
few days,
you know what?
Been tough for him.
I'm going to make him our Miller player of the game, moment of the game, call it whatever you want. 17 shots in the third period. The Miller light time of the game, and it'll be the whole third period. Thomas McCollum shuts out Tampa Bay. Good for you, kid. 17 shots unofficially, and a lot of them, at least 8 or 9 of them, were quality scoring chances. Way to go, Thomas McCollum. Small bright spot for the Red Wings tonight in a 5-1 loss. Good for you.
That's for his grandfather for sure. Great third period for Thomas McCollum as the Red Wings fall by 4 and Tampa Bay overtakes him for top spot by just a point. Now let's send it to the studios in Mickey York.